for Game Changers with Lisa Faulkner.
She's definitely an advocate for positive change.
She talks to people who's actually found their own niche in today's marketplace.
You're listening to Game Changers with Lisa Faulkner.
Lisa is a game changer,
and she's keeping it real. Entrepreneurs,
executives,
entertainers, ministers.
I'm gonna kick back with Lisa Faulkner for the next hour,
cause she knows what she's talking about.
And she's got it going on.
Game Changers with Lisa Faulkner.
Hello, everybody, and thanks for joining us for another hour of Game Changers with me, Lisa Faulkner. I'm your host, and all of you listening, I just want to thank you for tuning in, keeping it locked right here. That was a great, lovely hour with Risa B that just went off. They had a gangbuster of a time in here, lots of vivacious singing and good times here. Rick, what's going on with the monitors? I don't see the live. We are live. Well, we don't see ourselves. Well, viewing audience, if you are viewing live now, you can see us. Rick is just telling me that I can't see us. Well, that's no fun. Anyway, guys, thanks so much for listening this week. All of your continued support and encouragement means everything to us. We have a great hour coming your way. I promise you. You know I do the best to bring you the best of the Game Changers, and you know all the ways that you can continue to connect and listen to us right here on WAEC Love 860. Hope you're listening live right now on your radio dial, 860 AM. If you're not, you can listen online at love860.com. Listen and watch. That's what I'm asking Rick about. Why aren't the monitors turned on? So we can see ourselves as well, but you can see us while we cannot. So you can listen and watch. We're in the studio, and you can, if you got to go this hour, but you want to keep listening, you can listen to us on either of your radio apps. That's iHeart or TuneIn or iRadio Now. If you have either of those radio apps downloaded to your phone, you can look for WAEC Love 860 there and get the show live this hour. Hey, when the show's off the air, you can never miss them. You still don't have to miss a moment of the show. You can get us on iTunes. And Game Changers with Lisa Faulkner is also on iHeartRadio now. Yes, so you can get the podcast on iHeartRadio and iTunes. So there you go. Never a reason to miss a moment of your favorite Game Changers with Lisa Faulkner. Or go to YouTube. They're there as well. Or there's a podcast page as well, you know. Just never a reason to miss it. Go head on over to penstar.org and check out all the great newsletters, information about the show, and it'll lead you back to the podcast page. So never a reason to miss us, guys. And I love it when you follow, and I love it when you connect with me. You know how you do that? Follow me on Facebook at Lisa M. Faulkner, LinkedIn, Lisa Faulkner, Twitter at Penstar Lisa, Instagram and Pinterest, Penstar Lisa. I will check your comments and connect with you. Continue to connect with you there. Hey, Game Changers, we are live, and so are you. When you call 404-355-8699 or 866-923-2860, very dynamic, beautiful young Game Changer in the studio this hour you may just want to call in and talk to. Before I go any further with all of my hoopla, let me just dive right in and tell you a little bit about her. Then we're going to get her on the mic so that she can give you the full Monty, the full recipe. She is a writer, a speaker, and an entrepreneur who has a heart to see people experience the power of having a practical and transparent is the key word here, guys, relationship with God. Her passion for people to understand how life-changing it is to be intimately know Him, to intimately know God, is the inspiration behind her latest work. That's her book titled, How to Look Real Naked. You see why transparency is important here? What are you looking for, Rick? Hey, it's no naked pictures in here, Rick. It's no naked women in here, Rick. That's the title of her book, How to Look Real Naked. Phylicia is a living witness of how God's transformative power can take every area of your life to the next level and beyond. So since I've already said her first name, let me just welcome to the show Phylicia Goings. Welcome to Game Changers with Lisa Faulkner.
Thank you, Lisa. Thank you.
Oh, my sincere pleasure. Thank you for coming by.
I'm excited to be here.
We're excited to have you. This title of this book, you know what, this book is really something to behold, but, you know, the title is something to talk about as well. How did you come up with this title?
So I got word that I was going to write a book. I felt it in my heart. I knew it. I had talked to someone and they told me, they were like, the Lord said you was going to write a book. I said, well, it's going to be a few years, so you can tell him to hold on to that word because I don't plan on writing it right now.
Oh my goodness.
I was living in Los Angeles. Mm-hmm. And it just kept being pressed upon me. I would wake up out of my sleep every morning, couldn't get away from that word. And so I went to God and I said, you know, Lord, I'll do whatever you want me to do. Mm-hmm. But if I'm going to write a book, it has to be something that is going to help people and people want to read it. So wow. You have to give me the title and the content. I'm not doing this myself. And he spoke How to Look Real Naked. And it piqued my interest.
Wow.
As soon as I heard that on the inside of me, and the journey began.
I love that. Yeah. You know, it speaks volumes. It resonates immediately. Yeah. You may not know exactly what that means.
Exactly.
But it resonates immediately. What does it mean to you, How to Look Real Naked?
Like you said in the beginning, it's about transparency. Mm-hmm. And I think the title was very intentional because a lot of times when we think about God or we think about spirituality, we think about religion.
Mm-hmm.
But How to Look Real Naked is not about religion. It's about a relationship.
It is.
And that's what a lot of people are missing in their life. They're not getting results. And it's like if you have a relationship with God, you should be getting results. But if you're not consistently getting results, the only thing you might have is religion.
Exactly. So. That's right. You know what? We got to get Twitter pulled up here because Phylicia just said, if you're not getting results, the only thing you might have is religion. That's powerful. Yes. And that's so true. Well, you know, this book is also, the title is not only unique, the way that it's designed. Yes. I don't want to give it all away.
Yes,
because
don't give it all away.
Have to get the book. But we've got to pull them in, Phylicia.
Yes, yes,
we've got to
yes.
let them know what they can expect.
Yes, yes. Okay.
You know, I'm so structured. I always like something to guide me in my devotionals, in my time with God. So I've been using this book in my devotionals even, but it's not a real linear kind of structured kind of 1, 2, 3 devotional.
Right.
It's pretty dynamic.
Yes.
It's got layers to it. And for me, I'm always, you know, dissecting things, but I think it's got like 3 different layers to it.
Definitely.
What do you say about the way you design this book? There are like 3 different forces or voices coming through in this book.
Right.
Tell us about it.
So in the beginning, when I was working on the content, the Lord gave it to me in a way where I knew the book wasn't about me. The book was about him.
Mm.
So a lot of times you get material from people and they're telling you all these wonderful things to do and things that have worked for them personally. And then you take them home and you try to do it and you're like, well, it's not working as easily for me as it sounded like it was working for you. So the Lord had me structure the book in the way that if no one else is in the room with you but the book and him, you will get results from his book. If you're stuck in a job, in a relationship, in anything that you want to be free from, whether it's debt, anything you want to be free from, anything you want to be delivered from, you can read certain chapters of this book and God will speak to you directly and give you answers how you can get out of those things.
Wow.
So the book was written in a way to actually produce results.
Yes.
So it gets you into action. It kills procrastination.
Mm-hmm.
Procrastination kills dreams.
Yes.
And it kills the will of God being performed in someone's life.
Mm.
You have to be in action. And so that's what the book helps people to do. And so you talk about these 3 layers, not to give it all away, because, and you having read the book, you know exactly what we're holding on to. But I will say that if you are a person and you don't hear the voice of God speak to you on a consistent basis, reading this book, you will hear him speak to you every day.
Yes, I agree. I agree.
And people think you only listen with your natural ears. And that's kind of where the missteps occur, because God can speak in any way that he wants to.
But there's another voice in here, not only God.
Yes.
So that's kind of interesting, too, because I kept flipping back and I was going, now, wait a minute. Who is this other person?
Right.
Wait a minute. Phylicia, tell us about that.
Okay.
You have to tell us a little bit about that.
So the other voice, when I was a child, I heard God speak at a very early age and I understood it to be the voice of God. And when I got maybe 19 or 20, I started understanding the indwelling of the Holy Spirit, the Spirit of God living on the inside of all of us.
Yes.
And I was like, wait, there's a different name to this other than God.
Yes.
And so the Holy Spirit is that voice
yes.
that's guiding you through this journey through the book. That's another one of the voices.
Yes, I love that voice.
Yeah.
I love that voice. And it's so interesting, too, the other three characters in the book
yes.
who has all these pursuits
and these
questions that the Holy
and
Spirit...
wrong thoughts
that the Holy Spirit continues to have to teach and coach and talk to. And one of the characters is named Lisa. And Lisa is a lot like me. This Lisa is a lot like me.
Yes.
So that's so interesting.
And I know we're saying character. So the book is not a fictional book. It's definitely based on the word. But there are characters that represent a part of all of us in the book. So if you're a person, maybe you've been going to church all your life, but you really don't know the power of God, the love of God. Mm-hmm. You're not really getting results. You feel like you lose every time you go to do something.
Mm-hmm.
Then the book will show you other people that were in the same situation and how they overcame that.
Yes, that is so good. Now, Phylicia, I feel like you came here armed today with some messages for people who you believe, you know, God has a word for, that who God just wants you to tell people some things today. You know, when we were talking before the show, you said something just very powerful. Just kind of share some of those thoughts or information that you believe, you know, God wants you to share today.
Yes. So when I was leaving home to come here today, I know that, you know, there's the talking points from the book and people want to hear about it, and it's all wonderful and great. And I asked the Lord, I said, you know, aside from what I'll be talking about today concerning the book that you've written through me to help people, is there anything else that you want to speak live specifically to those that will be listening today? And one of the things that came up for me was, anytime you have a desire in your heart, or something that you want to do, a dream you want to pursue, something you want to engage in, you're excited, you're passionate about it, and you feel like you could do it, and then all of a sudden you get this voice that says, nah, I don't really have the money. Or nah, I work full time and I'm a mom, or I'm a dad and I don't know how I could do all that. Or nah, let's just not do it today. Let's start tomorrow. That voice never, ever comes from God. Anytime you have fear associated with anything in your heart that you want to do, it does not come from God.
Wow.
So I'm like, okay, God, you know, that's pretty basic, pretty simple. But then he began to talk to me while I was on my way here and say, if you could see the voice talking to you, you wouldn't listen to it.
Wow. If you could see the voice talking to you, you wouldn't listen to it.
So if your eyes were open to the Spirit, if you could hear if you could see the enemy, see what he looks like, see that it's not Jesus, see that it's not the Holy Spirit, see that it's not God, see that it's this foul, small, evil thing that doesn't even have half of the authority that you have in the earth, telling you can't do something, you're not going to listen to that voice anymore.
Exactly.
And so that voice is robbing people of their dreams. Because they're listening to it, thinking that it's God.
You know what? That resonates so much with me on a couple of levels, because I think when you first said it, it was so chilling, because I thought, oh, that's truth. And there's something about truth that when you hear truth, it's like a shutdown. It's like, You just have to be still and allow it to,
yes,
allow it to just be, because it's truth.
Yeah. And another thing, when you talk about seeing, seeing in the spirit, seeing in the natural, I won't get super deep with all of that. We, you know,
we can get deep.
Okay. That's great. And we can get deep. That's totally right up my alley. But for example, let's say your mother or your father or a close friend, you express, this is what God put in my heart to do. And they don't respond in a way that's in agreement and in faith. You got to stop seeing your mom, stop seeing your dad, stop seeing your friend, and see the enemy.
Yes.
The enemy speaks through people just like God can speak through people.
That's good.
If I can plant a thought in your head that says, no, don't do it. You're be fearful. The word says God does not give us a spirit of fear. So why would God give you a dream and a goal and then give you fear to go with it? That doesn't make sense. Fear comes from the enemy.
Fear comes from the enemy. Nowhere in the word, that's what the one of the two things that really makes that resonate for me. Nowhere in the word does fear come from God.
Right.
And two, the word even says when we get a chance to see the enemy, we're going to be like, was that you? Who caused me all this trouble? Was that you who caused me all that, you know, who wreaked all this havoc in my life, who I was so concerned about? And that's all that it comes from, the accuser, the enemy, the one who wreaks havoc, the one who causes fear. And that's so good.
And
so remember that, guys. Say it again, Phylicia. If we could see.
If when you hear negative voices in your thoughts, when you hear negative voices coming from people in your life, when you hear these voices speaking to you, you have to train yourself. You have to learn how to see who's saying that. You learn how, you have to see in the spirit. You have to understand in your heart, this is not coming from God. If you could see the voice speaking to you, you would not listen to it.
That's good. What are you listening to these days, Phylicia? What's happening with you besides the book? Well, we do have a caller. Well, let's take the call. Let's take the call. And then we're going to talk about where we can get the book. And then we're going to find out what else is going on with Phylicia. We've got a lot to discuss this hour. Let's take the call. Hi, caller.
Good evening.
Good evening to you. Thank you for calling. What do you want to say to us today?
Well, I just want to say congratulations, Phylicia. This is Michelle.
Hi, Michelle. You got through. Hi.
I did. Congratulations. I know you're doing great things. And I knew about what you, the direction that you were going in with your book. So I mainly want to just say congratulations. But also,
thank you.
What was your inspiration for writing your book?
Oh, man, my inspiration. I was living in Los Angeles, and I kept coming across people that found it somewhat amazing that I would hear from God, or that I would say things like, yeah, and the Lord said, and they were like, what do you mean the Lord said? And we would always end up in these conversations about having a relationship versus having religion. And so one day I said, Lord, just tell me, guide me to a book that somebody has written about this to develop a really intimate relationship with you. I'll buy like 15 or 20 copies from Barnes and Noble, keep them on me, and just sew them into people's lives. So instead of giving me a book to buy, he gave me a book to write.
Wow.
So that's how it, that was the inspiration.
Awesome. Awesome.
Thank you so much, Michelle.
Yes. Well, you know, I wish you all the best.
Thank you.
And congratulations again.
Thank you. And my nephew is actually texting me saying, say something about me. So hi, nephew. Hi, nephew, Sean Jr., and my niece, Anaya, and my other nieces and nephews in Mississippi. I'm glad you guys are tuning in.
Well, thank you for calling, Michelle.
Great. Awesome.
Thank you, Michelle.
You're welcome.
All right. Take care of yourself. So where can the listeners get the book, Phylicia?
The listeners can get the hard copies of the book from lookrealnaked.com. And there's a special for anybody that's listening today. If they use the name of your show, Game Changers, they will get free shipping on the book.
Excellent.
So visit lookrealnaked.com for the hard copy of the book. Now, the ebook can be purchased on iBooks, Amazon, Kindle, pretty much anywhere ebooks are sold.
Mm-hmm. Excellent. Yes. Well, y'all, I highly recommend you get it. It's a really fun, interesting, real good read, if I may use the word good. It's a simple read, simple word, but it's a right word for this. It's in, and it reads that it's a comprehensive guide to a deeply personal relationship with God that works. And it works because it's practical. You will relate to a lot of the content in the book. It will lead you to do some personal reflection. It will allow you the opportunity to, if you are one who likes devotionals and times to, if you're one who likes to take time to reflect, there's opportunities in the book for that as well. And it's just a time to, even the back cover says that it's an opportunity to take a journey through the pages of How to Look Real Naked, a simple yet profound book that is sure to dramatically impact your life. So yes. I agree. It's a good read. Congratulations to you. Good work. Good work.
Thank you.
What else is going on with you? This is not your home, but you have not been afraid to plant your feet in several cities. Mm-hmm. You have done some enterprising work in Los Angeles as well. Yes. And then you've done your due here as well. So tell us a little bit more about the entrepreneurial side of Phylicia Goings.
Well, the entrepreneurial side. So first of all, I'm from Mississippi and I grew up in Mississippi, and my mom had a salon and my dad had a club and my grandmother had a dress shop and my uncle had a pizza place and my other uncle worked on cars. So I come from a family of people that showed me entrepreneurship was possible. And I really think they instilled a really good work ethic in me, and they instill values in me that made me unafraid to just try something, unafraid to just do it. So I ended up moving to Los Angeles. I was taking classes in Los Angeles, working two jobs. And I went to God. And I was like, God, I'm working two jobs and I'm taking classes and something is still not adding up in my finances. I need you to help me. You love me too much for me to lack in any way.
Yes.
And so when I went to God about money, Amen. God gave me an idea. And I find that oftentimes when we do go to God about money, He gives you an idea.
Amen.
It may be an idea to start a company. It may be an idea to sow a seed. Mm-hmm. It may be an idea to stop doing something that you're doing that's depleting your resources. But nevertheless, a lot of times it's an idea. It's a word.
I love that.
So He didn't rain money down from the sky that day when I prayed. But I got an idea to start a company. And I ended up starting a service-based company in Los Angeles when I was 22. And you fast forward, just a quick testimony concerning that. So started this company, built a template basic website. I knew absolutely nothing about business. I launched the website. The next day I had my first customer, first client, completely booked, didn't know me from Adam, as they say. And I'm like happy, rejoicing. So I'm 22, two jobs, school, didn't have a car, anything. So I'm walking across the street to the bus stop to head to work. And I'm like, man, God, you're so good. You're so faithful. You know, you said start a company and I did, and you gave me the name of it. And I said, but wait, I don't even have money like for the things needed to execute and do all of this. And I said, but I'm going to trust you. 2 minutes later, the bus rolls up and a $20 bill rolled up with the
bus. Wow. There it is.
Nobody can tell me having a relationship with God isn't a game changer. I live it every single day of my life.
Having a relationship with God is a game changer. Oh, wow. That's pretty cool. We've got another caller. Oh. Hey, caller. Rick is our caller on. Hello, caller.
Good evening, ladies. This is Avery.
Hey, Avery. How are you?
I'm doing okay. Your guest said that she's from Mississippi. What part of Mississippi are you from?
I am from a town called Crenshaw, Mississippi.
Crenshaw. What's the closest town or what's the closest city that's Crenshaw from?
Tunica. It's 30 minutes from Tunica and maybe an hour and 15 minutes from Memphis, Tennessee.
Okay, then. The reason why I called is because... you know, back in the day, they had Jim Crow segregation, and we had to have our own banks and credit unions. And I was wondering, do y'all have your own bank and credit union in the town of Crenshaw? Because you was stating earlier about your family, pretty much everybody in your family had their own business. What's it say? God blesses the child that has their own. So I was wondering, do y'all have your own bank or credit union in that town?
Well, I know Mississippi has a bank, Avery, but you might have to call the mayor and ask him about that because I haven't lived there in years.
Okay.
So I don't know if they have their own bank or credit union, but I know there's a lot of great treasure inside of the people.
She made her way from Mississippi, Avery. Those are her humble beginnings.
Yeah, call the mayor.
She still honors Mississippi. Do you still get back there, Avery? What part of Mississippi are you from?
No, I'm originally from Chicago. I just heard when she was talking about her.
Oh, gotcha. And got
it. I consider Atlanta my home now, but I was wondering, do y'all have that? Because, see, back in those days, man, you know, we had our own. Like I said earlier, you remember the Black Pages?
Not familiar.
The Black Pages, where every major city had their own business. See, back in the day, they wouldn't allow us to post our businesses in the Yellow Pages or even the Business White Pages. So we created the Back Pages. So it doesn't matter if you live in New York City, Miami.
You know, I think I have received Black Pages before.
Yeah.
Well, Phylicia Goings is an aspiring author and an entrepreneur, and she hails from Mississippi. But she has lived. I don't think you've ever lived in Chicago, have you, Phylicia?
I have not lived in.
She's lived in Los Angeles, and she lives in Atlanta now. And she's here today talking about her book, How to Look Real Naked. Did you have any comments on a relationship with God or her book about how to look real naked?
Well, I can say that you know, well, the book is probably good, but you say you live in Los Angeles, so I know they have one in the Black Pages in Los Angeles. But like I said,
Avery,
I wish that we have a better unity today than we did back in the day. Because back in the day, man, we was forced to take care of each other. But thank you for taking my call, ladies, and y'all have a good weekend.
My sincere pleasure. Take care of yourself. We're going to get ready to take a break, and we will be right back. Keep listening, guys.
Daughter of Destiny is what God calls the dynamic woman of God, Dr. D. Greathouse.
Let me tell you something. My life is anything but normal when the Father and the Son are at the helm of it, and my best friend, the Holy Spirit, is guiding me every step of the way.
Dr. Greathouse's uncommon journey of life has led her to succeed, survive, and accept God's fresh breath of life into her destiny and the lives of everyone she touches through the prophetic gospel and teachings of D. Greathouse Ministries International.
When Jesus came to me in a vision and we were on the mountaintop, he said something to me that has resounded in my spirit for years. And he simply said this, "I have blessed you so that you can bless many."
Dr. Greathouse will empower you to walk in the purpose God has for you. Now is your time to experience God's miracles taught in Dr. Greathouse's personalized Gold Faith Package. You'll receive Dr. Greathouse's inspiring CD message, Faith, the Antidote.
I want to talk to you for a moment about the supernatural faith, which is a gift of God.
Learn how the gift of faith given to Dr. Greathouse gave her a personal testimony and an amazing healing from illness. Your healing will begin too as you read line by line of how she was able to forgive and minister after an unimaginable tragedy. She shares it all in her pages of her highly acclaimed book, What About Me? And from Dr. Greathouse's private vault, you'll also receive 1 gram of fine gold to remind you, as God reminded Haggai, silver and gold are his, and with it, he grants the great gift of peace. Get the entire Gold Faith Package today for your faith gift of $149.99 or for a gift of $14.99. Receive either the What About Me book or the CD message, Faith, the Antidote. Call 855-334-7316 or log on to thegreathouseministries.com for the Gold Faith Package today. That's 855-334-7316 or log on to thegreathouseministries.com today.
Do you need someone with solid, expert communications experience to write your copy or your next press release? Then you need PennStar Communications. Let PennStar communicate your greatest potential with clear copy written for your business and marketing needs. Whether it's your next event or next campaign, PennStar Communications can write that for you. Visit PennStar.org or call 404-828-0287 today.
If I ever took a loss, I learned a lesson. I won't ever think I'm better than the next man. I've been down before to come up, I ain't stressing. Baby, I'm too busy counting all these blessings. Yes, yes.
Canada. Line them up. Sweater sunshine on me, get my huddle, no matter the trouble surrounding us. They don't see that it's a lot of us. Everybody move anonymous. Won't take that credit, I know what we get it. Them blessings be coming from God above. I was doing all kind of bad, what a quiet. Hit the pew and tell God he is first. Hit the studio to body a verse. I remember pushing mama a little way high today with no gas money. I just bought a car cash money. I ain't even trying to brag on it. I just tell it how it really is. I ain't tripping, ain't feeling this. I ain't saying I deserve nothing. I'm just trying to talk about the benefits. I be punching in the clock, trying to keep the kitchen stocked. Man, it's a blessing because we ain't never had a lot. But all we need is all we got.
Whew. If I ever took a loss, I learned a lesson. I won't ever think I'm better than the next. I've been down before to come up, I ain't stressing. Baby, I'm too busy counting all these blessings. Count it up. I put my mama in the grip that stops stressing. I put my girl in a brand new diamond necklace. She said she need more of my love and affection. Cause lately I've been working harder than ever. She said, baby, you a boss. Baby, play a schedule. Darling, you a boss.
Excellent, guys. Thank you, Rick. Another great selection by Rick, the wonderful engineer.
Rick,
I wanted to come back to y'all sooner, but Phylicia and I were bouncing to the song.
Like
so
that,
we were
Rick.
Like, we like that. Positive vibes, great beat. We are back with Phylicia Goings for the hour, guys. She is a writer, speaker, and entrepreneur, and she's here talking about her latest book, How to Look Real Naked, and we're just having a wonderful time.
Yes.
We've had some callers this hour, so you too, if you want to call in and talk with Phylicia, she's providing some wonderful insight about what kind of led her to write this book, and really, the topic of the hour is how to have a personal relationship with God. That's what the book is all about. That's what Phylicia's heart is all about. And that's what we're discussing this hour.
Yeah.
It's really how to look real naked.
Mm-hmm.
The call, the hour is the call, the hour, the numbers are 404-355-8699. If the call needs to be on us, guys, we'll take it. And you can call 866-923-2860. If you're calling long distance from Mississippi, from her hometown, or from her home away from home in Los Angeles, you can call us at 866-923-2860. So, Phylicia, what do you want to share with us? Where were we going before we took a break? I want to learn more about really what you prescribe to others about how to have a deeply personal relationship with God that really works. What are really some practices that you say really work for you?
Right. So for me, we talked about the title of the book, Nakedness, being mm-hmm. transparency. So the first thing is transparency with yourself and with God. And so we talked about the nakedness in the book is dealing with that level of transparency. It means you allow yourself to be seen the way that you really are mm-hmm. without doing anything to cover yourself.
Yes.
For example, the book of Genesis talks about Adam and Eve.
Mm-hmm.
They did what they did. They didn't feel right about it. And the first thing they did was cover themselves
yes.
instead of going to God.
Mm-hmm.
So a lot of people are covering themselves with alcohol, with
yes.
food, with relationships,
yes.
with jobs that have prestigious titles
mm-hmm.
because they're really insecure. tour about what they're called to do, or mm-hmm. all these different ways that we cover ourselves.
Yes.
When you let go of who you're not, the real you will emerge.
Wow.
And you will experience a deeper level immediately in your relationship with God.
When you let go of who you're not, the real you will emerge. That's
and that's
good.
That's what the Lord gave me for the book. And the thing is, it doesn't matter where you are right now, what you look like, what you've done, what you said. It doesn't even matter if you believe in God or not right now. The key thing is being transparent about it and going to Him.
Mm-hmm.
I've met several atheists that didn't believe in God but would still pray if
yes.
a tragedy happened,
mm.
would ask me questions, would engage me in dialogue, but yet said they don't believe.
Wow.
So everybody has that space in them that God created for Himself.
Mm.
And until God is the thing or person filling that space, there mm-hmm. will always be a void.
Exactly. I totally concur. Totally agree with that. God is the answer. He so wants to fellowship with us. He so is waiting
yeah.
to commune with us.
Yeah.
And if we would just follow Him, if we would just walk believing
mm-hmm.
that, there are opportunities and people and $20 bills
yeah.
at bus stops waiting for
that
us.
That he can turn into $20,000
yes.
a year in additional income.
Yes.
And then from $20,000 go on up to the millions. That's what we're working on.
Every time he will do it. If he does it once,
yeah.
he'll do it again. So because it's all his to do it with.
It is. And a lot of people say, oh, God's no respecter of person. I believe that. God
mm-hmm.
is no respecter of person, but he is a respecter of faith.
Yes.
You're not going to come in unbelief and say, well, I don't believe and I'm not buying into this, but do something, twirl and show me what you got, God.
Mm-hmm.
No, it's a love. It's a mm-hmm. it's a deep love that supersedes any natural thing your
yes.
mind can perceive.
Wow.
Your spirit has to pick up on this and mm-hmm. believe it.
So is that one of the keys, you believe, to getting real results? That
yeah.
love, that faith?
Have love and faith, but really more so not being afraid of who you really are, where you really are. For example, like when you start, if a person is on a journey to getting out of debt, you got to
mm-hmm.
first understand how much debt you're actually in.
Exactly.
So when you go to God to initiate the deeper level, okay, God, I want to go deeper with you. You don't cover you. If you're having thoughts that, you know, they're impure thoughts, you be real, you
mm-hmm.
be honest. If some people journal,
mm-hmm.
some people talk out loud to God and he'll respond, but it's the authenticity, the thought that being myself isn't going to kill me.
Yes.
And sometimes we're afraid of being ourselves as if it's like it's going to kill us or God is going to be mad. He
mm-hmm.
already knows what
he
you're
knows
doing.
He knows so well.
So, I mean, you're telling him old news.
Surprise
yeah,
him.
It's old news. But what it does, and to be very clear with everybody, even though it's old news to God, it's your heart posture.
Mm-hmm.
Do you trust him enough to be vulnerable with him in every way? Do you trust him enough to say, you know, God, I flew off the handle at, you know, so-and-so this morning, and I know it wasn't right, but
mm-hmm.
I felt so hurt by what they said.
Yep.
And God may say, apologize.
Yes.
Can you go and be vulnerable with somebody
yes.
else and say, hey, I actually was offended by what I said.
Mm-hmm.
I wasn't confident.
Right.
I actually, that's actually a very insecure area
mm-hmm.
for me. Forgive me for going off.
Yeah.
That's what I mean by being authentic and transparent when you try to go deeper in any relationship.
That's good, Phylicia. Well, we have another caller. Caller, welcome to Game Changers with Lisa Faulkner.
How you doing?
I am well. How are you?
All right. This is Marius.
Hey, Marius?
Hey, Marius.
Yes, ma'am.
Well, welcome. What do you want to say?
I was listening to Miss Phylicia, and I was wondering, like, in your journey of finding yourself, and you want to bring your friend along, but it just don't seem like they're getting on the right path. How do you go about either moving on without that friend or trying to witness to that friend? Like, when do you know when it's time to let go and just trust God to either bring that friend along or just let that friend go into the wilderness? If those are the right choice words.
Oh, I completely understand you, Mars. So one thing in the book that God gave me was that it's his job to change people, not ours.
Mm-hmm.
Our job is to love people. It's God's job to change them. I used to be a person, if I had one disagreement with you, I would cut the relationship off. Mm-hmm. And it wasn't that the person was bad. It was because I was afraid of being hurt again. Mm-hmm. But God taught me how love endures. And you have to seek him. You ask God a specific question and you pray something similar to this. It doesn't have to be exactly this. Lord, remove any relationship or connections with any people that is not in your will for me to have. Ask him to do it. Because what you don't want to do is walk away from a relationship that God actually means for you to have in your life, a relationship that may be in a rough spot right now, but it's going to eventually work out good. So there's no answer where, yes, stay in the relationship, try to help the person, or no, get out of it, pursue what God is telling you to do and leave them alone. If you focus on being obedient to the Lord and having your relationship right with him, anything not in alignment with that will fall away anyway.
I agree. That's so good, Phylicia. What do you think, Marius?
Yeah, I think that's great advice, and I really appreciate you helping me with that. I do my best to try to reach out to those as I continue to grow. But just the fact of, I guess, them not being not moving along fast enough or not showing any signs, that will, if I pray and ask God to do his part, then that'll help me trust more in him and not be so, I guess, judgmental or impatient on the other person's behalf.
Exactly.
And it'll keep you from feeling guilty if you're not seeing results in somebody else's life. Because here's the thing, and it's just a quick detour. Jesus spoke to the fig tree, and it didn't die until 24 hours later because it started dying at the root. So just because you don't see something on the surface yet, God never not answers a prayer when one of his kids speak. That thing is going to die at the root. Now, whether or not you have time to stay there and watch that tree fall, that's between you and God. But understand, every time you pray for somebody, the Holy Spirit goes to work in their life.
Wow.
They have the authority to undo it. But every single time you pray, the Holy Spirit goes to work. So don't feel guilty. Don't feel condemned if the Lord does lead you to sever ties in certain relationships. You do not have to carry that. It is the Holy Spirit's job to change people, not yours.
I hear some powerful information coming forward, Marius. From Phylicia, I first heard her say, previously in relationships, she felt like if there were an argument or a disagreement, she would immediately just sever that relationship. I used to be much the same way, but I had to learn that just because there was a disagreement, that didn't mean the relationship was over. That just meant that there was a growth. There was time to grow. We just learned something different about each other, and we could grow past that disagreement. Yes. So when you talk to that person, y'all might not readily agree, but that's an opportunity for y'all to grow past that disagreement. And then two, I heard you say something really powerful, and I think Phylicia gave you some real information or some advice that's going to help you beyond that. You said if you don't see any change in that person, well, once you pray to God, he's going to give you direction to whether to make that change for yourself.
Yeah.
When you see that, when he's going to give you that appointed time too, because that fig tree is a perfect example too. He's going to give you that that appointed time when to make that change for yourself, because we don't want to immediately sever ties with people, because they may need time to make a change. Everybody doesn't respond the way that we want them to respond every time we need them to respond. But when we do see a glimmer of hope, a glimmer of light in people, sometimes we've got to rejoice
at that little bit.
To that person, or maybe that relationship that may be the one, or it may not be. But I agree with Phylicia. There's no real quick answer, fast, quick fix for it. But I know that God will lead you and give you the answer if you pray to him and if you listen for those signs and answers.
Most definitely. And it has to be specific. There is no formula. There is a formula in the book, but the formula is not for God. The formula is for us, is for people. That formula is thoughts plus words plus actions equals manifestations. Whatever thoughts you're dwelling on concerning the person, whatever words you're speaking out of your mouth concerning them, it's going to cause you to take certain actions, whether it's an attitude, whether it's cutting them off, whether it's keeping them in your life, you're going to get a manifestation out of that. But My thing is, and the reason why I believe God told me you have to stop cutting stuff off as soon as it doesn't look the way you want it to, is because how are people going to be ministered to if mm-hmm. all the Christians keep leaving them?
Yep. Ooh, that's
how are
good.
People going to know God if all the people that have God in them keep severing ties in relationships?
That's good.
God gave you a chance to grow. Sometimes we have to give other people a chance to grow. Now, on the flip side, we know stories like Abraham where God was like, leave your people. Leave your people because they ain't
yes,
going to come.
Yes.
So you got to ask God, God, you want me to leave my people?
Sometimes we know right. when it's time to go.
You want me to leave my people or you want me to stick yes. around and hang out to see this tree fall? Like
there will
Jesus
come would. A time yeah. when you will know it is time to go.
Yeah, that's a great question, though, man.
That's
I think a lot of people
question,
deal with
Marius.
That. I definitely dealt with it.
I hope
Thank you
get the book, How yeah. to Grill Naked. And there's a discount today when you use the Game Changers.
Yeah.
Code. And thank you so much for calling, Marius.
Yeah.
Keep listening to
thank
the show.
You.
And
thanks. Hi, for-
oh my goodness. Nephew.
So hi, thank you
June.
For all your help.
Thank you, Mari.
I know he's been reaching out to you with a couple of things I'm not able to answer, but I see he's reaching out to the correct person.
That's
and I
so
really
cool.
appreciate you yeah. helping him along his journey as well, because he's been getting very interested in it, and as far as Bible study and church, I do my best to answer what I can, but I know when he calls you, I know you mm-hmm. give him great advice.
Maurice, do you know this whole time I was talking to you, I didn't realize, this is my nephew's stepdad, everybody.
Oh my gosh.
So my brother's son, this is his awesome stepdad, his bonus dad.
Oh my gosh.
Maurice, hi, I did not know that that was you. I hear Junior in the background.
Hey, T gave it away.
Thank you guys for calling in.
Thank you for calling.
Bye, Junior.
Take care of yourself.
Great talk.
All right.
That was
wow.
pretty cool.
I did not know that.
The Haiti gave it away.
Me in the back. I thought he had called in and the call was intercepted on top of Mars, but I didn't realize that it was the name didn't even click that it's okay. Well, thank you. That's
well,
a great
that was
question.
A good call. Yeah. That was a good call. And either way, we got it.
Awesome.
So, Phylicia, let's take a really last quick break.
Yes.
And then we will come back and wrap up with Phylicia. I've got one more question for her, and then she can share whatever her heart's desire.
I got one more powerful thing to share.
We can just wrap up for the hour. Take us to break, please, Rick.
The Sankofa Media Group is a mass media company that creates socially responsible, informative, and entertaining content that reaches audiences all over the world. Sankofa Media's leading-edge technology and know-how develops winners into who they were created to be. Timely radio and talent like Blog Talk Radio's Abiding the Tripartite.
God tells us in His Word we can have what we say, but we are always saying what we have. You must believe to the point of expectation and you shall receive.
And Game Changers with Lisa Faulkner.
I want to talk to the game changers. I want to talk to the ones who the game was changed on, but yet they triumphed. I want to talk to the people who provide a platform for others to change the game for themselves.
Sankofa publishes messages of love, hope, and redemption that connect with us where we need it the most.
The book, What About Me, is a story of the kind of faith and courage that engages the reader to reflect personally and spiritually, especially in these uncertain times of today. It's a great thought-provoking page-turner.
If you're ready to step out of the boat and join the Sankofa Media Group in showcasing your God-given gifts and talents, contact us today at 855-334-7316. That's 855-334-7316.
Molly, let's go get him!
Give me that joy I can't explain. An extra piece that'll ease my pain. Come on, that love that'll never change. Give me that,
give me that,
give me that,
give me that.
Give me that power to walk away. When another God wants to take your place, as much of you as I can take.
Whoa.
Give me that. Give me that.
Oh, anybody ready?
Oh,
ready for His glory?
Oh,
if you are sick of a life,
oh,
let me tell you the story.
Oh,
every place that's dark,
oh,
He will bring it to light.
Oh,
hypocritical hearts, backsliders, liars, time to get right.
Oh,
See, I include myself. Uh-oh. I cast my own stone. Uh-oh. I'm the man in the mirror, y'all. Uh-oh. I can see my wrong. Uh-oh. But I'm here by grace. Through Christ by faith. Uh-oh. I had to make that choice. I had to open up my mouth and say,
give me that joy I can't explain. Add extra peace that'll ease my pain. Want that love that'll never change. Give me that,
give me that,
give me that,
give me that,
give me that power to walk away when another God wants to take your place. As much of you as I can take. Give me that,
give me that,
give me that, give me that.
Oh, anybody tired?
Uh-oh.
You want the show to end?
Uh-oh.
Get the actors off stage.
I was jamming, Rick.
Yeah, I was jamming.
I was raising my hand, jamming, y'all. He thought I was telling him to bring the music down and come back on. Well, either way works since we only have a short time left.
Yes.
So we need to get back on here and close this great hour we have had with Phylicia Goings, a writer, speaker, and entrepreneur here on, we're going to call it her book tour.
Yes.
We're going to say we're kicking off her book tour of How to Look Real Naked here at the Game Changers with Lisa Faulkner Show. So I just had really one closing question for you, Phylicia.
Yes.
You talked about, and I love this quote, when people, you said when you let go of who you're not, the real you will emerge.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I don't know that people really know how to let go of who they're not. I feel like sometimes people are just following patterns and they fall into what they're told to do,
mm-hmm.
or what their family does or what their background is, or they don't really know their gifts and talents,
right.
or they haven't been honed in such a way,
right.
and they just are fall into this life pattern of getting by. So how does one really uncover who they are and what they were truly created to be? What is your recommendation?
It's the same way you buy a blender and you unwrap the box and the plastic when you get it home, and you read the manual that comes with the blender. Every human being has a manual that came with us, and it's the word of God.
It's
the Bible. We cannot get outside of the Bible. It's not outdated. It's not just for people of a older age, people that are 80s and 90 years old. No, for the child, for my little nephew who's 10 years old, who hears God speak, who ministers to people. So you have to go back to the manual, unwrap. So you're taking off the paper, you're taking off the plastic, all of the fake stuff that plays no role, has no bearing on the blender actually working.
Wow.
Doesn't mean you can't wear makeup and get your hair done and weave and all that. I love getting, you know, jazzed up. That's not what I'm talking about. I don't want it to be misconstrued. But you go back to the word. And I remember being like, well, God, you know, how do I just be myself? It's like, find the moment where you know you're being yourself in your life, and what are you doing?
Mm-hmm.
A lot of times it's not that you're doing something, it's that you're not doing certain things. You're not laughing when you're really in pain.
Mm-hmm.
You're not having an attitude because you're really in fear.
Mm-hmm.
You're very authentic.
Mm-hmm.
You go to God the same way and you ask God, what did you make me to do? Who am I? You tell me. And God will begin to give you scriptures. He'll begin to uncover certain things for you. Now, one key thing I must make note of, we're not aiming for perfection with this relationship with God. We're aiming for progress.
Wow, that's good.
Every day of your life will be progress to being more and more of yourself in the earth.
That's good, Phylicia. One quick caller, and then we will get ready to wrap up here. Hi, caller. How are you? Hello, caller. Welcome to Game Changers with Lisa Faulkner. What can we do for you? No one is there, so we will keep going. Phylicia, what do you want to share before we close today?
One thing I want to leave with people, this is something I encountered a lot in Los Angeles and in Atlanta and traveling and just talking to different people about God, even with believers, surprisingly with believers, is that they don't hear God speak to them personally.
Mm.
So I'm going to tell you how to open that door, tell you how to tap into that. A lot of times you go to church, you hear other people's revelations, or like you listen to a radio show and you hear people saying, God said to me. It is so imperative. If you're going to know who you are, you have to be able to hear the voice of the one that created you.
Mm-hmm.
And so one of the things, it happened to me. I went a few days not hearing God, and I was like, God, I can't live not hearing your voice. Help me, Jesus. I can't live not hearing your voice. And I had gotten busy. I got busy with my company, busy with other things, and I wasn't doing the same thing, taking the time to listen and to hear. And what God taught me, he said, it's not that I don't call everybody. It's just sometimes people have their ringer off. Mm. Just like you have your cell phone, and somebody's calling, and then a few minutes later, you look at the phone, and you're like, oh, somebody called, but my ringer was off. I didn't hear it. Mm-hmm. So if you're waiting on an important call for a job or for a deal, what are you doing? You're mm-hmm. in expectation.
Right.
It's the same way with the voice of God.
Thank you for listening to Game Changers with Lisa Faulkner. For more details about anything discussed on this program, go online to www.penstar.org. That's PENSTAR.org. Be sure to follow Lisa on social media. And be sure to subscribe to the Game Changers with Lisa Faulkner podcast on iHeartRadio and iTunes.